The only thing I remember from that day is walking peacefully home from a pickleball game and going into my house. 3 days later, I woke up in a hospital. I don't remember anything about what happened. I just remember dreaming that I was walking home quietly, peacefully.
Ray Giles likes to play pickleball with his friends and neighbors in West Roseville. But 2 months ago, in the middle of a match, he dropped to the ground.
Ray took a big tumble down. We thought he had a muscle cramp.
His teammates quickly realized, though, the muscle in Ray's body having trouble was actually his heart.
When he went down and he was unconscious and not breathing, that this was a major, major event.
Immediately, Jacob Stark and Brianna Spaeth were among those who began trying to revive Ray.
Started CPR right away and yelled for call 911 and got things started.
And then I called 911. I went out there. I noticed the AED wasn't being used yet.
For 10 minutes, several people took turns giving Ray CPR and shocking him multiple times with the AED machine to restart his heart.
My heart literally stopped.
Within 10 minutes, Roseville Fire got to the scene.
It kind of was almost like tunnel vision.
It felt both fast and slow for those saving Ray, since performing CPR is very physically taxing.
It was very exhausting because we hadn't performed it, but we did recognize right away it was pretty serious.
To be done correctly, chest compressions need to be timed properly and done with a lot of pressure.
I'm a little sore in the chest where they broke my ribs to get my heart beating, but I feel fine.
The Roseville Fire Department awarded Brianna, Jacob, and three others who helped Ray that day with special honors over the weekend for their life-saving efforts.
We would like to thank these special folks and present them with the Chain of Survival Award.
It's exactly 2 months ago that I was in a hospital dying, in effect. Oh, I feel great. I'm very grateful and very thankful.
Those who were there that day are also grateful to have saved Ray and to have known how to.
You never need to know how to do it until you actually need to know how to do it. And then at that point, it is literally life and death.
People being CPR certified or trained in CPR is probably one of the most important things that you can either do for a family member or do for a friend.
But for now, Ray is just focusing on the present.
I've got a new lease on life, as they say. And I feel very grateful that everything has worked out for the best.